So you guys are actually doing a free screening for, is this for anyone or who should be interested in this?
So unfortunately, it's not for everyone. There is a criteria that right. has to be met.
Right.
An individual must be uninsured.
Okay.
They have to be 55 to 77 years of age.
Is that where most of the lung cancers
are
present
found.
Themselves?
It is. Okay. It is. And with this grant, they also, or with this screening rather, they have to have smoked one pack of cigarettes per day for 30 years
okay.
or two packs for 15.
Okay.
And for some people, they say, you know, I can't believe people still smoke that much, but they do. And so that's what this event is all about, providing okay. lung screenings to those that are in need.
Yeah. Is that still the primary cause that we're finding for lung cancer is smoking, or are there other environmental factors that you're starting to see creep in?
So there are environmental factors. However, for lung screening, the criteria still lies with smoking.
What if someone out there used to smoke heavily but stopped? Because as I understand it, the lungs have an incredible capacity to heal.
They do.
Or do they have to be current smokers?
They don't have to be a current smoker, but they would have had to have smoked in the last 15 years.
Gotcha.
And still that pack year history. And
gotcha.
So they still would have had to have smoked one pack of cigarettes per day for 30
gotcha.
Years or two packs for 15.
Still a lot of people. So Elaine, tell us your story. How are you, first of all? Are you still on your journey?
Yes, I am. I will finish treatment in either February or March.
Awesome.
And then we'll start doing periodic CT scans.
Gotcha. Would this have helped you, did you find your lung cancer early enough?
No, I did not. I did not even know that I had it. Was in the hospital for non-related issues and was not feeling well one night. I mentioned it to the nurse. And they contacted the doctor and said, take her down for a CT scan with contrast, and that's when it was found.
Wow.
Is that what you're finding, that a lot of folks don't even know they have lung cancer? Or tell us about some of the symptoms that we should be on the lookout for.
So some of those symptoms are chronic coughs, blood that's in the mucus or in the phlegm, those that are wheezing. But we don't want everyone to think that just because you have a chronic cough
that means
or
you have lung
wheezing
cancer.
That
yeah.
I have
yeah.
lung cancer.
Right.
That's certainly not the case. However, if you find that it's progressive and or it's just not subsiding, that's something that you want to bring to the attention of your primary care physician and not just let it go by the wayside.
How treatable is it if found early?
So if found early, the survival rate, if it's still found within the lungs, is 56%. However, we're finding that once it has spread outside of the lungs, survival rates then are less than 5% in 5 years. And
wow.
so these statistics are staggering and alarming.
Wow.
Yes.
So that's where you
yes.
caught it early, right?
No. I yeah. was at stage 4 when it was caught.
Wow. My goodness.
Because I had no symptoms whatsoever, or any symptoms that I had were attributed to my COPD.
Gotcha.
Okay.
And those are often related, are
yes.
they not?
They are, and
yes.
they're very similar.
Were you a smoker, Elaine? And what would you
yes.
say? What would you say to others?
I started smoking when I was 17 years old.
Yeah. Well, we didn't know back
right.
in the day. And now I read just the other day that 1 in 5 children are vaping, which can be, as I understand it, just as dangerous. What would you say to folks who think it's not going to happen to me?
I always said it was not going to happen to me. I had chest x-rays every year. This does not show on chest x-rays.
Really?
So you could have lung cancer and not even know it.
Yeah.
But if you have anything at all, chronic cough, or say you don't feel quite right in the chest area,
yeah.
Let your PCP know.
Yeah, just check it out.
Just check
it
out.
Well, God bless you as you finish
Thank
your
you.
Treatment. And thank you so much. So people do need to make an appointment to be screened.
They do need to make an appointment.
Okay.
They can call 901-922-6781 if they meet that eligibility criteria.
Awesome.
And we would love to see them on Friday.
And all that information is right there on the screen. Thank
yes.
you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
God bless
thank you.
You.